Hello everyone, I am Dhananjay Dhatunde from Department of Food Engineering Technology, Tejpur University. Today I am going to give a presentation on the topic Pulse Light Technology in Food Processing. The contents of my presentation are as follows: Introduction, Principle of Pulse Light System, Design of Pulse Light System, Flowsheet of General Pulse Light System, Effect of Pulse Light on Microbes, Effect of pulse light on food quality and components, factors affecting on the microbial inactivation, applications, conclusion and reference. Let's see the introduction of pulse light technology. Pulse light technology is an innovative non-thermal technology. It is a process of sterilization of foods by using high intensity light pulses within a short duration of time. Pulse light technology involves the use of inert gas flash lamps, which converts short duration and high power electric pulses, that is those used in the pulse electric field technology, into the short duration and high power pulses of radiation included in the spectra of ultraviolet light, visible light and infrared light. The term pulse light is known since from the year 1980. And the application of pulse light technology in foods is approved by Food and Drug Administration in the year of 1996. The pulse light operates under the wavelength of 180 nanometer to 1100 nanometer. The visible light has a wavelength of 400 to 700 nanometer and the UV light has a 180 to 400 nanometer. The UV light is again subdivided into UVA, UVB and UVC. UVA has a 315 to 415 nanometer. UVB has a wavelength of 280 to 315 nanometer and UVC has 180 to 280 nanometer. The UV light is responsible for the bacterial inactivation in foods and nowadays an efficient technique of sterilization as developed for the treating packaging films. Now we'll see the principle of pulse light technology. It is the non-thermal method of food preservation that involves the generation of pulse light with gradually increasing energy from low to high and then releasing the highly concentrated energy as a broad spectrum burst to ensure the microbial decontamination on the surface of foods and the packaging material of foods. Within the fraction of second, the electromagnetic energy gets stored in the capacitor and is then released in the form of light within a billionth of second, which results in the power amplification and the minimum additional energy consumption. So these are the principles involved in the pulse light technology. This is a functional diagram of general pulse light system. It consists of supply of high voltage DC power, energy storage capacitors, pulse shaping inductors, flash lamps which produces radiant energy, that is light, and then this energy is triggered on the target. Now we will see the generation of pulse light. How actually the pulse light generate? A very large pulse of current is sent through the ionized gas, which excites the electrons surrounding the xenon atoms, causing them to jump to higher energy levels. The electrons release this energy and drop back to a lower orbit by producing photons. The figure shows the schematic representation of a xenon field flash lamp. In this, the pulse operation of xenon discharge lamps is characterized by two stages. First one is plasma formation near the anode and second is plasma decay stage. This is the flow sheet of general pulse light system. In this, low power, low voltage, low alternating current is sent to the electric converter, where alternating current is converted into the directed current. Then this low power, high voltage, low DC continuous current is sent to the electric capacitors, where this current is converted into low power high voltage and high DC continuous electric current. Then this electric current is sent to the electric pulse forming switches, where the pulses of high power, high voltage, high DC currents is generated, and then these pulses of current are sent to the inner gas flash lamp, where the pulse light is generated, and this light is triggered on the target. Now we will discuss the mechanism part of pulse light system. Effect of pulse light on the microbes. The lethal effect of pulse light can be due to, first one is photochemical effect, and second one is photothermal effect. The photochemical effect involving lethal effects of light pulses on the some constituents of the microbial cells, and in photothermal effect due to the temperature increase determined by heat dissipation of light pulses penetrating the product. These are the mechanisms of microbial inactivation. Let's see these mechanisms one by one. First one is photochemical effect. As DNA is the target component of the cell for ultraviolet wavelengths, so primary target is nucleic acid. In this, ultraviolet light is absorbed by the conjugated carbon-carbon double bond in the DNA, which changes the structure of this DNA or RNA, and this causes to non-enzymatic repair. So, also this process forms some pyrimidine dimers. These pyrimidine dimers inhibit the formation of new DNA chains in the process of cell replication, resulting in the collagenic death of affected microorganisms by ultraviolet light. Second one is photothermal effect. This hypothesis become evident by when scientists observed electron microscope photographs of flashed Aspergillus niger spores presenting severe deformation and rupture. Concerning the photothermal mechanism of microbial inactivation, it has been already introduced that the most energy of light pulses that penetrate through a food product is absorbed by the layer nearest to the surface and dissipated as a heat, which causing the in such thin layers a certain increase in temperature. Since microbial cells have a higher absorption of pulse light than that of the surrounding medium like water, this determines the localized rapid heating of microorganism, which at very high pulse power power values can reach temperature about 130 degrees Celsius, which is sufficient to cause their overheating, rupture and death, and the extremely short pulses of duration prevents the microorganism cell surface from being cooled by the surrounding medium. In this, the ruptured top of spores become evident of an escape of an overheated content of the spores, which became empty after such an internal explosion, and evacuation of its content took place during the light pulse. Now we will see the effects of pulse light on food quality and components. There are some positive effects and some adverse effects also. So, in adverse effect, the pulse light treatment at doses lower than 5 joule per centimeter square prolong the microbiological shelf life by 2 to 3 days without affecting the product quality, whereas higher doses caused strong decay of texture, significant reduction in vitamin C, antioxidant properties reduction, and the promoting the enzymatic browning. The extent of all such undesirable phenomena generally increased with increasing treatment time and decreasing distance from the lamp. Only minor changes in color and texture were observed. In positive effects, the ultraviolet pulse light treatment at a fluence of less than 10 joule per centimeter square resulted in a significant increase in vitamin D2 in freshly harvested white button mushrooms and mushroom slices, which is already known effect of ultraviolet continuous light without undesired discoloration. Pulse light treatment for just 10 to 90 seconds is able to enhance the anthocyanin content up to 20 times, depending upon the pulse light dose, and the consequently the red color of the skin of poorly color figs. So these are the effects on food quality. Now we will discuss the factors affecting the microbiological inactivation. So these factors are the type of microorganisms, interaction between light and substrate, and the distance from the light source. Now we will see these factors one by one. First one is type of microorganisms. So different types of microorganisms have different properties. Some of these are very susceptible to pulse light, and some of are very resistant to pulse light. So the optical properties of cells, like degree of scattering and absorption of light, are the most affect the microbial inactivation. As degree of scattering of light increase and the absorption of light by the cell is decreased, it reduces the effect of pulse light treatment on the microorganisms. Also, the incident beam of light undergoes the refraction due to the difference in the optical density between substrate and the surrounding air. So this refraction reduces the penetration power of pulse light, and hence these factors affect the microbial inactivation. Next factor is integration between light and the substrate. For transparent and colored food materials, refraction is particularly relevant, whereas for opaque food materials, reflection is the prevailing phenomenon. For smooth surfaces, specular reflection is there. For rough surfaces, diffuse reflection is there. And for translucent material, scattering phenomenon is there. Regarding target parameters, in order to obtain effective pulse light treatment for microbial inactivation, a food item has to be highly transparent to the desired wavelength. This first means that the product surface should reflect as low as possible. Apart from this, the higher absorption coefficient, the more efficient the inactivation effect. And the higher product transmission coefficient, the deeper the penetration of light. Due to that, the such effects is achieved. Next factor is the distance from the light source. As the distance from light source and depth of the substrate is increased, the absorption of the light by the product or the microbial cell decreases. The quantitative distribution of light dose inside the substrate is described by the term optical penetration depth, which represents the distance over which light decreases influence rate to 37% of its initial value. The shorter wavelength, deeper the penetration into the food. Now we will see the application part. There are number of applications of pulse light treatment. Apart from these, some important applications are as follows: disinfection of air and water for aseptic applications. Then inactivation of spoilage and pathogenic microorganism in food products, surface microbial control of food, then disinfection of utensils and surfaces, then disinfection of packaging and closures. These are the some important applications of pulse light treatment. Advantages of pulse light treatment. The intensity of light that lasts for only a second, and it is 20,000 times brighter than the sunlight, but there is no thermal effect, so quality and nutrient content are retained. Second one is, this treatment can be used for the treatment of foods where the rapid disinfection is required. This treatment is lack of residual components and the absence of applied chemicals, disinfectants and preservative. So there is no external additive is added in the food. Fourth one is, foods with smooth surfaces such as fresh whole fruits and vegetable commodities, hard cheeses or smooth surfaces, meat slices are suitable for treatment with pulse light where surface contamination is concerned for the microbial contamination. And last one is, this technology is eco-friendly. That means this pulse light treatment does not produce any type of pollutant and does not cause to any type of pollution. There are some disadvantages of pulse light treatment as follows. First one is, effective penetration is still a challenge to this technology. Higher installation cost. Third one is, thermal effect in food powders. Fourth is, limited pulse light efficiency because of shadow effects. Then food with rough or uneven surfaces like grooves or pores are unsuitable for the pulse light. Then not an adequate technology for cereals, grains and spices due to their opaque nature. And last is, loss of light sensitive nutrients. These are the disadvantages of this technology. Now we will see the industrial relevance of pulse light treatment in food sector. The application of pulse light technology in the food industry has been gaining more attention and potential applications, especially in the last 10 years. The use of pulse light technology to decontaminate food packaging materials is the most concrete application. However, the use of pulse light technology to decontaminate food still require more efforts to achieve industrial scale of direct food decontamination. At the current level, few pilot scale studies have been carried out and revealed important considerations. Here we conclude our presentation. The pulse light process is a promising alternative for microbial inactivation. Pulse light treatment achieves effective microbial inactivation in much shorter processing time and at lower energies than conventional thermal sterilization, thus better preserving and nutritional and sensory properties of food, particularly if the temperature increase is properly controlled. There are some microbial species resistant to pulse light processing technique also. Finally, it is necessary to carry out studies on the large scale in order to introduce this disinfection technique at the industrial levels. These are the references. Thank you.